holding?
Yeah.
Okay, one in the box, one in the left, there's one coming at me, release, don't throw.
Well, here it is. 12 long years in the making. I never thought I'd get here. I remember day after day telling myself when I get here I was going to hit these streets running as fast as I could get it. Now look at me. My feet feel like blocks. It's all I can do to carry my weight out the parking lot. I ain't gonna lie, I am scared to death. I think I got a job, all right. Dad said I could stay with him. That's not really an issue. Kind of worried about my health, though. On and off again, I've kind of fought with mental issues when I've been in here, been depressed a while, and just some medical issues. I have not a clue how I'm going to take care of them when I get out. For instance, what do I do if I get sick? What happens when I need more prescription medication? Man, there are a lot of sick guys around here. What happens if one day that happens to me? If I get high blood pressure or diabetes? How do you take care of long-term illnesses like that? I've got a pretty good doctor on the street, but how in the world do I get a copy of these medical records to him? What do I do if I kind of start to feel stressed out or depressed? Or maybe I just want to feel like I need to talk to somebody besides myself. Well, I can see right now that it's going to be real important to stay as healthy as I can, but I don't even have a clue how to get started.
Let's stop and go back. There are a lot of thoughts running through your mind as you leave prison. Depending on how long you've been inside, outside could be a lot different than when you left it. It may seem scary and make you anxious. There are people and services inside the prison that can help you prepare for the day you leave. The more you learn and the healthier you become while you are inside, the more likely you can stay healthy once you get out. And if you are healthy, you are more able to keep your family healthy. Don't wait until right before you leave to think about getting ready. The sooner you start, the better off you and your family will be. This video is to help you learn what you can do while you are serving time and how to find resources to help you stay healthy on the outside.
How healthy can you go? How healthy can you go?
What do I do if I get sick?
It's important to stay as healthy as you can, no matter where you are. If you get sick, the first thing to do is let someone know. You can get a sick call slip in your living unit and fill it out.
All service?
Yes, sir.
Can I have a sick call slip, please?
Yes, sir. There you go.
Thank you.
You have a good day.
All right.
Write down your problem and place it in the sick call box. A nurse will review it and let you know what to do next. You may need to see a nurse or a doctor. If that happens, you will be told when to go to medical for your appointment.
How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
All right, have a seat up here for me.
That way you can tell staff directly what the problem is. If it is an emergency, tell the officer in your dorm or your caseworker. They will contact medical and get help for you. If you or anyone in your family gets sick in the free world, you do have more options to get help. You might think the hospital emergency room is the best place to go, but that should be saved for real emergencies, such as an accident, a head injury, a broken bone, or a situation when you need help getting to the hospital. Because your life is in danger, you can always go to the doctor's office, but there are other places to go. There are immediate care centers in the community that are set up like a hospital. You don't need an appointment, you sign up when you get there. The wait to see the doctor is usually shorter, and it doesn't cost as much as the hospital. In some pharmacies, there are clinics where you may see a nurse practitioner who can find out what is wrong with you and write prescriptions for medicine. This usually costs less than the doctor. It is also more convenient because if you get a prescription, you can get it filled right at the pharmacy. Clinics are located in nearly every neighborhood. If you don't know where these clinics are, you can look it up on the computer, or there is a hotline service you can call. This service is operated by inmates at Reuter Correctional Complex. They have access to computer information and can look up resources for you if you can't find them on your own. That number is 877-466-2834 and is in the paperwork you are given when you leave. Whether you visit the immediate care center or the pharmacy clinic, it's important to take all your medicine exactly how the doctor tells you. If you have an infection, you need to finish all your medicine, even if you start to feel better. That way it has a better chance to get completely rid of the infection. If you stop taking the medicine before it is all gone, the infection may come back even stronger and be harder to get rid of. If you notice a change in your health, don't wait until it gets out of hand to get help. The sooner you address an issue, the better chance you have of taking care of it.
What happens when I need my prescription medication refilled?
While you are in prison, your medication is provided to you free or for $3 if it is a non-formulary drug. A non-formulary drug is one that is not on the Department of Corrections approved drug list. This means there must be special permission from the medical director for you to get the medication. They are more expensive, and that is why there is a fee to the inmate. The nurses order your medicine from the pharmacy and have it ready for you at pill call when you need it. If you are taking medicine for lifelong or chronic illness like high blood pressure or diabetes, you are allowed to keep this medicine with you in your room if you have a place to lock it up. This is called the Self-Administered Medicine or SAMS program. You let the nurse at pill call know when you need a refill by filling out a refill slip, dropping it in the refill box located at Med Central. If you take narcotics or medication written by a psychiatrist, you must come to the pill call to get it one dose at a time. The pill call nurses order those for you when they are about to run out. You can ask the psychiatrist to tell you the names of your medicine and when they will run out, so you can help make sure that your medicine is available. When you leave prison, you are given a 30-day supply of your prescription medications to take with you. Before you go, you can make arrangements to get an appointment with someone on the outside who can write you a prescription for medicine. You should start this process 6 to 8 weeks prior to your release. Your unit administrator, pre-release coordinator, classification treatment officer, librarian, and medical staff may be able to help, but it is up to you to take care of this. Prescriptions are expensive, but there are some places that can help. If you have trouble paying for medicine, there are places that have prescriptions for $4. Tell your doctor you want one of the drugs on the $4 list. There are also websites and clinics that provide free medicine if you qualify. One of these websites is freemedicine.com. This information will be given to you when you leave.
How do I take care of a long-term illness like high blood pressure or diabetes?
Medical providers, nurses, nurse practitioners, and doctors are available in the prison to help take care of you. They will make sure you get a follow-up appointment to see that you and your health conditions are addressed. You show up to get your blood pressure checked or get blood work done or to receive your insulin every day. Medical staff will ensure that the supplies necessary to monitor your blood pressure or diabetes are on hand, such as syringes, alcohol swabs, and AccuCheck strips. In the community, you will need to get a doctor to oversee your health as soon as possible. You can see either your private physician or report to a clinic. If you need a follow-up appointment, the medical staff will inform you as to your next appointment. You may be able to check your blood pressure or blood sugar levels on your own. There are various types of blood pressure monitors at most pharmacies that you may use free of charge. You may also purchase a monitor from your local retail store. In doing so, you can check your blood sugar with your own monitor and strips in the convenience of your home. You will need to record by writing down your levels and take these recordings to the doctor upon your next appointment. This record will help the doctor decide an appropriate treatment plan. One of the most significant factors in treating high blood pressure or diabetes is your lifestyle. Eating nutritious food and getting regular exercise will improve your health. In order to determine an appropriate exercise plan or regimen, please speak to your physician.
How do I get a copy of my medical records to my physician on the street?
It is important that your doctor knows all about your health issues, no matter where you live. It is a good idea to get your prison medical health record to your new doctor as soon as possible. There are two ways to do this. One will cost you money, and the other is free. To get your records free, have your doctor call Institutional Medical Records and request them sent to him directly. If you get them yourself, you will have to pay for it. Contact your unit staff to help you get your records.
What do I do when I start to get nervous, lonely, anxious, or just simply want to talk to somebody?
There are times when everyone feels anxious, sad, and even depressed. That doesn't mean that you need to drink, smoke, or take a pill. It doesn't mean that you need to revert to prior criminal activity or shut yourself off from the world. Always talk to someone instead. Many people turn to family, friends, and in a lot of cases, to professionals. In the institution, caseworkers, unit staff, and psychologists are available to help. If it is not an emergency, you can complete and turn in a medical slip requesting someone to talk to you. It will be reviewed, and staff will let you know when an appointment with mental health professionals is made. Mental health staff provide various options for you, including individual consultations, support groups, group therapy, and medication if necessary. On the outside, there are many options, including a mental health professional, either in private practice, with a particular group, associated with clinics, hospitals, or with local community or public health agencies. And remember, this transition, along with life itself, is difficult, and it is normal to have these up and downs. Don't be discouraged. Help is available.
How do I stay as healthy as I can?
Staying healthy is a lot of work, but it can be a lot of fun. Eat healthy, exercise regularly, take your medication as required, and follow up with your doctor. For example, when you visit the canteen, make good choices about the food you purchase. Skip the candy bars, sodas, and chips. Buy the items that are going to give you nutrients, protein, and energy, like fruits and vegetables. Being healthy is also a choice you must make. Don't put yourself in a dangerous situation which could affect you and your family in the future. Avoid and eliminate risky behavior during your incarceration. Once you leave and return to your family, you will already be on the road to better health.
Hi, my name is Devin Martis. I'm a dialysis technician here at KSR, and I'd like to introduce one of my patients, Curtis Cook. And I'm just going to ask him a few questions if you don't care.
I don't care.
Okay, tell me about yourself and about your medical treatment.
Well, I'm a dialysis patient, and the reason why is because I made bad choices when I was on the street. I was a drug user. I never did pay attention to my health. So therefore, I'm on dialysis.
Did you follow your doctor's orders?
No, not at first. I waited a year before I followed his instructions. And then when I got back to see the doctor, it was too late. My kidneys had failed.
How's your health right now?
My health has improved. It's improved over the year. I've been on dialysis over a year now, but my health has improved.
Is it harder to take care of yourself while you're in prison?
No, it's not that hard. You know, I pay more attention to what I'm doing because, you know, I'm confined and I'm in prison. So, you know, I listen to what the nurses say and what the guards say. So, therefore, you know, I'm getting better treatment.
Why are you on dialysis?
Hypertension and drug use. I was a drug user from early age, you know, by 17, 18. And, you know, and I experienced in marijuana, and then I experienced in cocaine, you know. And I was just on drugs, and it had messed my health up.
And what could you have done differently?
Not use drugs and pay more attention to my doctor, you know, because, you know, I was out there doing things that I had no business doing, but, you know, this, now I'm paying for it. And if I was anybody out there who was on drugs or have bad health, I would see a doctor immediately to take care of myself.
Is dialysis any different in here than it is on the streets?
Well, yeah, it's a lot different because when I was on the street, I could do anything I want to. I can go in and stay an hour, 2 hours, you know, and then I get back out there and do what I was doing. But then, you know, the nurses told me that if you keep doing what you're doing, and it's gonna take your life. So, you know, I haven't used drugs since March of 09. So therefore, you know, I'm feeling a little better. I'm doing a little better. So I'm just glad, you know, that I quit doing them and still, you know, here to tell about it. Because I don't want to see nobody else in the shape I'm in, you know, because it's not no picnic. It's really bad when you're on dialysis, you know. It has a effect on you, on your whole body, now, you know, and your family too, you know, especially if you got kids. You know, I have kids, you know, they didn't know how to, you know, they didn't know how to take it at first until, you know, they let my daughter and my son come to the facility and watch me take dialysis, you know, then they got a better feel about it, you know, therefore, you know. But hey, it ain't no picnic. I advise anybody that's doing drugs or if their health is bad to seek medical treatment immediately. That's just the way I feel.
Successful reentry into society depends on you. If you take advantage of the mental and physical health services available, you will be in good shape to make the transition. However, once on the outside, you must follow through with your medications, medical, and mental health treatment plan. It's really up to you. How healthy can you go?
How healthy can you go? How healthy can you go? How healthy can you go? How healthy can you go? You go healthy as you want to go. That's all on you. If you feel a little bad, then you know what you should do. Put in a sick call and tell them your problem. And the medical department will be sure to solve them. Don't wait too late, cause that ain't a good look. You saw what happened in the video to Mr. Cook. It could be a headache or cardiac neurosis. Or a feedback from taking too many doses. Whatever the cause, don't leave it left alone. It don't matter if you in prison or if you're at home. So when you think of treatment, think of John Doe. Cause I really wanna know how healthy can you go? Now come on. How healthy can you go? 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 How healthy can you go?
877-466-2834. The number to the clinic. If you ever feel the need, call them up. Concerned about your status and disease, hit them up. How healthy can I go? I try to stay in shape. I'd rather eat some fruits and vegetables than eat a cake. Life is motivation, that's why I'm skipping rope. Stay burning cardio, cause I ain't trying to have a stroke. Be good to yourself, care about your health. Exercise, see the doctor if you're feeling short of breath. Nobody but yourself can give you what you need. Get in shape, find treatment. If treatment's what you need,
come on. How healthy can you